Jesus. Come on and reach out to him tonight. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I can say it's good to be here tonight.
Amen.
Somebody wasn't able to come, but I thank God. Hallelujah. He give me a mind to come to the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Receive what he has for me tonight. Come on and put your hands together one more time. And give him a praise. Thank you, Jesus. Without God, I can do nothing.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Come on and shout him out of praise. How many can say Hallelujah. 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 You know whatever you need tonight. Who's got it?
God got it.
I said, who's got it?
God got it.
God got just what we need tonight. Amen. I mean, it was ours for the asking. I know.
Oh, thank God he rose. Amen. And we can rise. Amen. Thank God I rose one day. Did you rise one day? Hallelujah. In the Holy Ghost. Praise God. New life. We thank God tonight for his grace and the blessing to be in the house of God. One more time. Amen. There ain't no better place. Ain't no better place than we can even imagine. Amen. Amen. And in God's presence. Amen. In the house of God. That's a blessing. Thank God for his grace keeping us through another day. Amen. We know somebody didn't make it through today, but we're here tonight. And because we're here tonight, we owe them a praise. Hallelujah. Look at somebody, look at me now and say, you owe them a praise tonight. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. You owe them your best praise. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Because God is good. He's been good to us. And he is worthy tonight. We thank God. Amen. For his goodness. Amen. We like the amen. And give him honor tonight to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Do you love Jesus tonight? If you love him, shout, I love you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. And we'd like to stop and give honor to our wonderful pastor. Amen. Pastor, have your servant. Thank God, the woman of God. Amen. We do honor. Amen. Double honor tonight. Amen. Worthy of double honor. We thank God. Amen. And we just thank God for another revival. Amen. And we, amen, use this occasion. Amen. Appreciation to our pastor also. We thank God. Amen. Glory to God because she is worthy. Amen. Tonight. Amen. And we thank God for every one of you coming out. Amen. To worship with us on tonight. I'd like to give honor to all you men and women of God. Thank God. Amen. For Pastor Leonard. Amen. And his congregation. Amen. Seek your place to worship him with us again on tonight. Thank God. Good to see the Pastor Biles with us tonight. Amen. God, thank God for you on tonight. We honor you. Amen. First Lady Sister Leonard, thank God for you on tonight. Amen. Any more pastors, amen. Amen. We give honor to you on tonight, to all the ministers of the gospel. Come on, clap your hands for all the ministers of the gospel tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. We do thank God for everybody in the house. Thank God for the musicians on tonight. We'd like to honor all the laborers in the house of God. Thank God for our Bible study teachers, Sister Diana, our video recorder, Sister Keisha. Amen. And Sister Jeff for filling in the sound tonight. To all the ushers, amen. Sister Davis, amen. Amen, Sister Essie, praise God, Brother Dorn, and just everybody, amen, that's leaving, amen, for the Lord on tonight. We just thank God. I do thank God for my beautiful wife also, King Levi. Amen. Thank God for all of his blessings. How many know you blessed on tonight?
Amen.
Hallelujah. God is good, ain't he?
All the time.
All the time. Praise God, praise God. Amen. Before I go any further, I don't know if, amen, if Secret Place got any, amen, and sing us tonight, praises tonight, want to come to us. Amen. Before we, glory to God. Father, amen. Thank you, Jesus. We receive them. Amen. Right here. Come on, clap your hands, church. Glory. Somebody shout glory. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Just give him a second to get our music. Sister Betty said, keep on talking. You must go. I don't like to talk, Sister Betty. I just like to get to it. Hallelujah. It just feels good to be back at home. I just miss everybody. I love everybody.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, just give God a hand. Into your freedom, just give him a hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Because he didn't have to do it for you, but he did. He didn't have to save you, but he did. He didn't have to raise you, but he did. I'm so glad that he put me on all my faults and he gave me what I need daily.
Thank you.
Praise God. Come on, put your hands together. Amen. For the amen. Selection of praise. Amen. For the mighty God we serve. Thank God. Amen. For secret praise and worship. Amen. Praise team. We thank God for that tonight. Amen. At this time, we're going to, amen. Praise God. Have a scripture reading. Amen. My own sister. Amen. Diane Williams is going to come give us a scripture reading right here. Come on, clap your hands. Praise God. Come on, clap your hands for this scripture reading. Oh, thank God for the word of God. Look at somebody and say, hang on in there. Don't you ever quit. Praise God. Hang on in there. I do thank God. Stop and give thank God for our mothers on tonight. I stepped up. Thank God for our mothers, Mother Betty, and Dr. Mother Camilla. Amen. Mother absent tonight. Let's thank God for all the mothers. We ain't got but a few, but we thank God for them. Amen. That hanging in there. Amen. We just appreciate the Lord. We're going to just give space for a testimony or two right here, man. Just a testimony or two. We're going to ask you to come preach. Amen. But if God does something for you, then be a blessing to the house of God, the body of Christ. We're going to give space tonight. Come on, Sister Gwen. We miss you. Somebody beat you to the punch the last time.
Out of your mouth. So when I got up, Brother said what God told me. Yeah. The devil still, he come trying to touch my body. But God said, greater is he.
Yes.
Glorify the holy name of Jesus.
Come on,
amen.
Come on, give God praise tonight. God's good, amen. He is who we say he is. He is our everything. Amen. I know the hours are all late. I want to give space to the man of God to say something tonight. Pastor Miles, if he will. Say a few words. Don't hear from him much. Amen. So thank God. Amen for having him tonight.
Somebody help me give God a good old praise offering. Somebody help me give God a good old fashioned. Holy Ghost. Praise offering. You know, I don't know if we just sitting here tonight, but I was just so excited coming down the road because I realized we were coming before tonight a God that ain't empty handed. And I learned this a long time ago, Pastor Anderson. You come to church looking for nothing. More than likely, you ain't gonna get nothing. But if you come looking for something, you certainly can leave with something. And I have every intention tonight to leave with something. I already been blessed. I mean, with the prayer and the songs of Zion, already been blessed. So it ain't no telling what God might do for us in this house tonight. I really believe you know without a doubt that one day we're gonna stand before the true and the living God. You know, let me. I think I shared this with Pastor Leonard the other day, and if I could leave here tonight with you to understand it. This scripture here has done more for me, ratifying my attitude towards God and the things of God probably than any other scripture. The scripture says, the eyes of the Lord, they're in every place, beholding the good and the evil. So I wanted to tell you that to let you know, whatever you do, wherever you go, God done already got there before you got there. And you ain't gonna do nor say nothing that God don't know about. I heard you, Pastor. I try not to pastor. I try not to preach when I ain't supposed to preach. But it's just so good tonight to be in amongst the men and the women of God. And I understand my friend, Pastor, he gonna break us all some bread. So I'm gonna leave. And if y'all ain't careful, I'm gonna eat y'all's too.
Come on, give God a praise tonight. Come on, give God a praise tonight. Amen. We're going to break it up right here because I know the man of God is ready to have a word for us tonight. Amen. I'm in the red for the word tonight. So I guess we're going to receive it, man. First lady. Amen. Mr. Leonard going to come. Amen. One and only great man of God tonight. Give us what God got for us tonight.
even though we're family, but they was best friends. Every time I see her, I just feel the glory of the Lord from her. And she always got encouraging words, and I just want to tell you, I love you. I would never tell mama, but you outcook mama. Hope she don't hear me in heaven, but you always outcook. But I appreciate the Lord. Let's give the Lord a hand clap and praise for Brother Leonard. Appreciate my honey tonight. Appreciate a man that I see God. 3-4 in the morning, he always walking the floors. One night he got on his tie, hollering, fire, 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 right there. He was in a vision. He thought, I guess he seen the glory of the Lord, the fire began to consume the house. But I woke up, I was scared to death, y'all, I ain't gonna lie. But it was all right. But I appreciate the Lord tonight, and I love you, honey. And y'all receive him with a hand clap of praise.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all sin and evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and the glory is thine. Father, we thank you, Lord, for what we feel in this service tonight, Lord. God, we thank you for the prayers, the testimonies, Lord, the songs, Lord. God, and we just thank you, Lord, for you being in our midst, Lord. And Father, we ask your blessings upon Sister Anderson, Lamb of God, and this church. And Father, we just ask you to continue to speak to us tonight and give us what we need, Lord. And Father, we thank you, Lord, for all that's in attendance tonight, Lamb of God, and give us what we need. And we'll forever praise you and magnify your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Let every heart say amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah.
no secret. Tells us that all have sinned come short of the glory of God. I don't care who it is. I don't care what their title is. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Amen. I'm so thankful you can be seated to have this opportunity to stand before you all tonight and take part in this revival. I want to thank the church coming out and supporting us. You know, we was in. Amen. We was in revival ourselves since Friday and through yesterday. Then Brother Tyrone, he has to go to work tonight. It's a blessing. People will take time out from their jobs to come out, help hold your hands up, and people being worked all week and churched all week. It's a blessing. Amen. And so we honored to have Bishop Bowers here with us tonight. Dear Bishop, I lean on him a lot, you know. And you got somebody you can call on, and you don't call on them, that's your fault. Especially when they tell you, call me if you need me. Hallelujah. Like that song says, you can ring my bell, I'll be ringing his bell. How many knows, man? We need wisdom. We don't have it all sold up as pastors. Sometimes we make some huge mistakes. And you need somebody to call and get some advice and get some wisdom from us. And I call him. Amen. Brother Benjamin, raise your hand back there, please, or stand up. That's Brother Benjamin back there. Precious brother we met when we had to open that revival. Say hello. If you ever need somebody to come and give you a good singing and praise and worship, his group does that. They go all over. And they're just a blessing. We thank you for being here with us tonight also, my brother. Love and appreciate it. Amen. Hallelujah. If you have your Bibles, come with us, please, to Mark 13. Hallelujah. Sis, I guess you could bring me back where I was. Hallelujah. Mark 13th chapter. And my jacket, my glasses is in my jacket. Hallelujah. Mark 13. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Love the Lord.
Amen.
Brother Bailey, glad to see him tonight. Amen.
Amen.
Told us he would come with us, and we're just so thankful.
Hallelujah.
See him tonight. Thank you.
Sorry for any inconvenience there, but thought there was any. Oh, here they are.
Sorry. I'm caught up, y'all.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So thankful for my darling wife.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I love my wife. Because when the book says when you find a wife, you find a good thing. I don't feel comfortable calling her a thing. That's what the book says. But I'm so thankful for her being so faithful all these years. And you got a woman that walks that floor in praise and standing in the gap fasting, prophesying. Don't mind telling the truth. That's something you need to thank God for. Amen. So thankful for her. And love you, honey. Appreciate you. You have your Bibles. Turn with us, please, to Mark
13th chapter. Go begin reading at verse 11. And it says, but when they shall lead you and deliver you up, take no thought beforehand, but ye shall speak, neither do ye premeditate, but whatsoever shall be given you in that hour, that speak ye. For it is not ye that speak, but the Holy Ghost. As a thought we would like to speak on, when the Holy Ghost speaks in that hour. Or that hour when the Holy Ghost speaks. There's coming an hour throughout the whole world that the Holy Ghost is going to speak. You know, man thinks that he can do whatever he wants. Man thinks that he got control over everything. Man thinks he can set things in order the way he wants them to be. But he's overlooking one thing. They got a God that created the heaven and the earth. That's going to be God in the beginning, he's going to be God in the middle, he's going to be God in the end. And the book says that heaven and earth is going to pass away, but that word, which is Jesus, shall stand
forever.
I remember years ago, Brother Terrell had a dream or a vision. And in that vision, all over the world, the devil was just taking full control over everything. And everything was being satanic. Everything was being evil. And he said that he was crying out to God to help us and deliver us. He said all of a sudden, he saw a huge giant that was asleep, that woke up. And when he woke up, and when he stood up, he began to defy the very powers of Satan. He began to knock down every kingdom. He began to destroy every element. He began to take charge of everything that the devil had took charge of, and he defeated the devil. Hallelujah. Don't you get discouraged. Don't give up on God, folks. Because everything don't look like it's going the way it ought to go. Don't you think God is on some vacation somewhere and ain't doing nothing about it. He sees that devil. Hallelujah. He sees us too. You know what it is too? God will allow us to go through things just to see if we're going to honor what we're standing up singing about. And see if we're going to honor what we stand up testifying about. See if we're going to honor what we stand up preaching about. See if we're going to honor what we stand up acknowledging. Folks, it's not just about what we can say for God. It's about how we live for God. Anybody can talk, but can't nobody live it. Now it's time to separate the men from the boys. If you're going to be a Christian, let's be Christian. And I ain't talking about if you're in a church where a man is married to a man and a woman is married to a woman. And I don't care if they call them first man, second man, third man, fourth man, fifth man. They're going to A-T-double-I-S-T. If I was at my church, I'd tell them they're going to hell, but I ain't at my church. Hallelujah. Man and man and woman standing in God's pulpit. You know what God says? He says, when you see the abomination of desolation standing in the holy place, he talking about that Antichrist that's coming. Don't you think that that Antichrist is on some vacation? Don't you think that that Antichrist ain't trying to infiltrate our churches? Don't you think that Antichrist ain't trying to infiltrate your home? Don't you think that Antichrist ain't trying to take you over? Somebody got to stand for Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He shouldn't have to look no farther than you and I.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Lord,
hallelujah. Listen, Matthew 10. Hallelujah. I feel the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Matthew 10.
Verse 16. Behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. Be ye therefore wise as serpents and harmless as doves. Folks, sheep in the midst of wolves will be devoured. But God has let the devil know. You the devil, we know you the devil, but I got some sheep that's going to come and destroy you. I got some sheep that's going to come and let you know you might be a wolf, but they ain't running from you. You might be a wolf, but they ain't scared of you. You might be a wolf, but they ain't going to be devoured. Hallelujah. God don't need no coward soldiers. If you friend of the devil, you friend to stand up for truth, you stand to stand up for righteousness, you don't need to be in nobody's pulpit. Hallelujah. You're a bitch woman, that's all right. But you say you got a call of God on your life. I don't care if you're evangelist, apostle, prophet, teacher. I don't care if you're somebody that's not a God. You got to have some backbone. You can't just be quitting. Hallelujah. Like the preacher was saying Sunday. Said so discouraging. You see a man or woman of God. They get up and talk about the goodness of Jesus. Hallelujah. They said 3 months later, you can't find them. 12 months later, you can't find them. They done gone out there in that world. Folks, somebody got to stand and withstand against the wiles of the devil. Hallelujah. You know what? We ain't going to be here forever, sis. We try to teach our church to learn how to stand on your own 2 feet, sis. Because one thing about it, if I die the day of tomorrow, my church is not my church, our church. I hate using my and I, that ain't me. I'm sorry. You do it,
that's you and God.
I don't do it. That church should not fall if I die the day of tomorrow. Instead of Leonard died the day of tomorrow. You know what they teach you in the military? I was 20 years in the military, sir. They said if that leader leave that unit and that unit cannot function in his absence, he wasn't a good leader.
That's right.
That's just the bottom line. That's the way they teach you in the military. Hallelujah. If you something happened to that leader, the church, that unit should still be able to function, folks. If you can't function without your leader, something wrong with the leadership in that building. Something wrong with the leadership in that organization. It ain't about us. You know what it is? So many leaders want to be on top. So many leaders want everybody to acknowledge them. So many leaders want everybody to think they're the only one that got in a bag of chips. They ain't got nothing without Jesus. Jesus is the only leader that got it going on. And we don't teach y'all how to look to Jesus, look to the hill for what's coming to your help. We ain't teaching you, right? Hallelujah. Man, our son, something hit his body a few months ago. And you know what? He ain't called me. I'm his dad in his pastor. He ain't called me. You know what he did? He started talking to God.
Yeah.
He went to the doctor, still hurt.
Yeah.
You know what he did? He challenged God.
Yeah.
In a respectful way.
Yeah.
You know what he told God?
Yeah.
He said, God, if you ain't going to give me a miracle, tell me why.
Tell me why.
Tell me why. If you ain't, I'm living right.
That's
and I'm doing what you told me to do.
That's right.
Paying my tithes, obeying God, praying, fasting, and I'm sick.
Yeah.
And you ain't going to give me no miracle. You tell me why.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God didn't answer right quick either. You know what he did? Stand up, Nisha. Where the mother knows that? They hear? He called his wife. The other book said, one could put $1,000 fight, two could put $10.
Yeah.
Man, that's why husband and wife shouldn't be fighting.
Yeah.
Man, because you got a charge to do.
Yeah.
You get together with you and your spouse. Man, that's 10,000 demons you can run out of your house. Yeah. And don't think they ain't in there.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Like last Sunday, Sister Lily started ministering to some couples. Tell them how God and blessing, God giving word, God.
Man, they just shout.
Lord showed me just that night before they were fussing and raising H-E double hockey stick. Let's get real now. People think when they get saved, that's all the trouble's over with. People think when they marry a minister or they marry somebody else that's saved, all the trouble's over with. That's a lie from a pit of hell. And I tell you one thing, you marry somebody that's young, they will act like they're young.
Amen.
You got to grow in this thing. Hallelujah. Sister Leonard had to be patient with me, sis. Sister Leonard was saved ever since she was 16 years old.
Yeah.
I was born and raised in New Orleans. I didn't get saved until I was about 18 years old. And when I got saved, I had a whole lot of things that wasn't godly. Oh! But she loved me to the fence. You know what else she didn't do, sir? She ain't put my business out the street. She ain't gonna tell everybody, brother, they're struggling with this, he's struggling with that. She ain't do that, bro. But hallelujah, when I got strong enough to stand, she ain't had to say, brother, let it nothing, brother, let's go pray. Yeah. And we did. You know what she did? She hung with me.
Come on.
You know what she said? Brother, we need to go to church.
Oh,
he had the key to church, too. 2 o'clock in the morning, we wasn't breaking in. Wasn't breaking in the scale, not said. We were breaking in to hit that altar. And I was so glad, man.
Thank you.
I didn't get mad with my wife when she was telling me my faults.
Yeah.
I knew it and she knew it. I couldn't hide from it.
Yeah.
See, that was the thing here. People trying to hide. Yeah. It didn't matter when you know you ain't doing something right.
Yeah.
And then when the spouse find out that you're hiding and doing something, they're going to trust.
Can't
trust.
Can't
trust. And then when you get up to sing or play music, wonder why.
Yeah.
Everybody else shouting on the plate, your wife looking at you like, hey. And keep it real, man.
Come on.
You're trying to be honest here, man.
Yeah.
God trying to raise up some true-hearted people, man.
Yeah.
Me and my wife are talking on the way here tonight. We're so thankful, man. You don't have to practice sin, folks.
That's right.
Folks, you can live a life without sinning.
Right.
People may not believe that. I didn't believe when I was young either. When your flesh needed God, you want to hide the world. But I'm trying to tell you, if you get a hold of God,
right,
and you shout out to God, you ain't gonna want sin, man. You ain't gonna want to do all that hellish stuff.
No.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
If you got desires in your heart that you know ain't godly, between you and your spouse, can't be in marriage. If it ain't godly, it ain't godly.
Amen.
Some things ain't should be done in the bedroom.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm just being honest with you. Lord trying to help us tonight. But we got so much lust in our heart and we want our spouses to go along with that stuff.
Yeah.
Don't work, man. Somebody got to lift up a standard.
Yeah.
Somebody got to be holy. Somebody got to be righteous.
Yeah.
Somebody got to say, man, I know this stuff is wrong.
Yeah.
And I love you, baby, but I just can't do that.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. We were young ones, folks.
Yeah.
We were young, sis. Like I said, we ain't had nobody teach us these things. We was on our own.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Full of lust.
Right.
Full of lust. For all that foolishness.
Come on.
But somebody hung in there long enough with us to let us know, if you pray to God, you shout out to God, God will deliver you. Hallelujah. Man, don't sit in here acting like you got it together. I see your heart.
Hallelujah.
I see your heart. God trying to help you tonight.
Right.
I wasn't even preaching on that. But I know the Spirit of God.
Yeah. Yeah.
Some of you got sin in your heart and you're in this church
right.
tonight.
Right.
I ain't just saying you're a member of the church. I'm just saying you're in this church tonight.
Right.
And God trying to help us to get that stuff out of us, folks. It hinders the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
It hinders God from moving.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Man, listen. Everybody has been through something while they were growing up.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I wasn't strung out on no dope, but some people bound by that stuff. But God helped me with dope.
Yes.
Man, your vessel in the temple of the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
And you need somebody to tell you that, because the word tell you that.
Yes.
But we're so caught up in self, want to please self. See?
That's right.
You know what folks will do? They'll walk out the door, mad with the preacher now.
Yeah.
Because he tell them the truth. Instead of them just getting in them altars or at their seat or in their heart and say, Lord, woe is me. You miss your deliverance, folks. You miss your opportunity to get free from them bondages. All of us have them, folks. I ain't trying to tell you something that I ain't experienced. I'm just trying to tell you how the devil will trick you and make you think you're getting away with something. If you go to God, you got to take 30 minutes repenting. You know what I'm saying? At least you got enough sense to repent.
Yeah.
But the thing of it is, if you repent before you do it, you might not do it. God trying to help us, folks.
Yeah.
We don't have to fall short.
Yeah.
God's glory, I hate the devil. I hate him, sir. I hate him with a passion. I don't like what he do. He hates me and and I hate him. So we got that understanding. I can't stand him. He can't stand me either. And every chance I get, I'm going to talk about him. I'm going to expose that rascal. I used to try to hide with that stuff, bro. I was in a denominational church that didn't preach against this stuff.
Yeah.
I was in a denominational church that let you get up in that pulpit and preach, baptize folk, give communion, all that, and you got sin in you.
That's right.
Folks, that ain't right. God ain't just turning his head. You know, Bible said once God looked at that stuff, you know what he said, you're not required man to do? Repent. And that's what he said. We teach folk in our church. I don't care what sin you commit. Only thing God wants to do to them. That's it, sin. That's it. He ain't asking us to go to the cross. He ain't asking us to get stabbed. He ain't asking us to take no pound of thorn. He ain't asking us none of that. All these things are just repent, man.
Yeah.
Listen, I feel your spirit. Your husband and wife did not happen. You're not happy. You're not happy. Your wife ain't happy. I feel your spirit. I didn't come to preach then, but God showed me your heart. Man, humble yourself.
Yeah.
If your wife telling you she needs your love, she needs to tell you she loves her, tell her you love her.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, I feel your spirit. God trying to help you. Then you wonder why. Wonder why they go out and try, not saying this right now. I ain't saying this right. But they go out looking for some love from somebody else, see? And you a minister. You're a child of God. Ain't wrong with you telling, nothing wrong with you telling your wife you love her.
Right.
Ain't no sin, sis. Till
right.
You come together with your wife.
Right.
What else are you supposed to come together with?
That's
right. God trying to help you tonight. Some women in here starving for love. I'm just telling you like it is.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
I ain't never had that problem. Stop, baby, stop. Girl, we ain't preaching. We ain't fasting. The books is buried under fire. I'm trying to help y'all, folks. That's the way I preach, y'all. I can't help it. I'm just trying to keep it real with you. Because you'd be surprised the many couples that we counsel that have been married and ain't happy. Can I be honest with you? I was praying just to walk in the fold just 2 nights ago. They had a many sisters, not just one. Many sisters. That come for us to counsel. The husband right there. And they say some of them got 5 kids. Ain't never been satisfied in the bedroom.
Come on, talk about it.
I'm just being honest with you. I'm just trying to talk.
Yeah.
Like I got some sense. But if we had a bunch of grown folks here, I'd tell you where the T.I. is. But that woman, just let her sit right there. The woman told her. He done. Am I lying? Quiet. It's quiet. I'm telling you what the woman told us. She was starving for love, sis. Had 5 kids and never was satisfied. Just because you get yours, get up, beat on your chest like you taught her, that don't mean that woman satisfied. Slow down and help her out, man. She's stressed out. She got to cook. She got to clean. She got to take all kind of H.E. double hockey sticks, and you come in here acting like she don't even exist. Trying to help us.
Come on.
I didn't come to preach on this, folks.
Right.
I promise you, you can look at my notes. God trying to help the church.
Yeah.
Tell you now.
Come on.
You act so holy.
Come on.
Till you go to bed with these granny gowns on. Man, I don't see no granny gowns now. If it is 90 degrees outside, she got one of them flannel gowns. That ain't God. I'm just keeping it real, man. We have to counsel people like that, man. I'm serious, Deep. Try to help folks. They're so holy. They got everything covered up from the neck on down, and they're about to go to sleep with this spouse. No, man is visual, folks. I'm just being honest with you. Man, visual. He's just like an octopus. Hands be everywhere. You know? I'm just trying to help us. Because when you come to church and you can't get through, you can't pray to God, you can't lift your hand because you're all mad.
Come on.
Because you ain't satisfied.
Come on.
And it starts at the house.
Yeah.
My wife told me years ago, she said, darling, you want to come together with me today? You need to start way in the morning.
That's right.
I got wisdom.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I start 3 days ahead. Then the Lord can't just jump up there and do things. I'm trying to help y'all, man. Ain't nobody taught us this, bro. I'm just being honest with you, man. I know what people are going through, bro.
Yes, sir.
We have been all over this country preaching. You'd be surprised at some of the things that we got to counsel couples about, sir. I'm just being honest with y'all, folks.
Yes.
God's trying to help us. Because like he teach us, a strong house, strong church.
Yes, yes.
Ain't that right?
Yes.
Weak house, weak church.
Because
we need help.
Yes. That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I'm finished.
Hallelujah.
Anybody need prayer? That ain't what I care to preach on and talk about. Yeah, I let him have it. When he comes in, I get out of the way. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Anybody need prayer tonight? God trying to help us.
Amen.
God trying to help us. All.
Amen.
We can be happy in our marriages.
Yeah.
Right.
We can be happy, see?
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Thank you. Y'all have any oil? Now I got some in the truck. God just trying to help us, man.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
You can be happy.
Amen.
Don't need no other woman to make you happy.
Come on.
You go out there talking to them and tell them what your wife ain't doing. You know what she gonna start doing? Everything she ain't doing.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Right.
Then when you get them, God trying to help us, folks.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. It ain't about me. About him and you.
That's right.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you.
Hallelujah, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
Father.
Glory.
God.
Thank you, Jesus.
She's wanting to live a Christian, Lord, but it's somebody that just treating her wrong. But she still want to be a Christian in the process. So we pray, God, that you strengthen her, God. God, give her the Holy Ghost, Lord. God, give her the mind of Christ, Lord. God, one thing about you, you love in spite of what they've done to you. And your words say, by this shall all men know that we're your disciples, by the love that we show one to another, God. So, Father, as she's being honest tonight, Lord, and don't want hatred or bitterness or anger in her heart, we pray, Lord, that you guard her heart tonight. And give her the strength, Lord, to have the love of God.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. I love Jesus, for it. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Like I said, I ain't coming to preach that, but God be glory.
Amen.
We love.